Hello and a very good afternoon. It's 1 p.m. You're watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Frank Pereira. Time for Verdict 2015. Here are the headlines. 57% voting in the phase one of Bihar polls. All major parties predict a comfortable win. No untoward incident reported during voting in phase one. Elderly and women vote in large numbers. Prime Minister holds rally in Jahanabad after Election Commission's approval. Opposition had lodged a complaint against the rally that coincided with the first phase of polling. And today we throw the spotlight on Imam Ganj, where two Dalit heavyweights are facing off in a battle of votes and prestige. Well, after a high-pitched, bitter campaigning, the first phase of five phases of elections to Bihar's 243-seat assembly concluded on Monday. Over a span of 2 months, rival camps led by Prime Minister Modi and Nitish and Lalu Prasad, on the other hand, traded barbs and counter-barbs. Here's what happened during the first phase of polling, which saw a 57% voter turnout.
The first phase of the high-voltage Bihar Assembly elections have come to an end. People queued up outside polling booths from 7 in the morning to cast their votes.
ये तो देश के प्रति मेरा कर्तव्य है मुझको पहले आकर और वोट कास्ट करना चाहिए
नौजवानों को रोजगार हो यही सब है और क्या प्रोग्रेस मतलब होना चाहिए
मुद्दा तो यही है कि मान ले बिहार में शांति हो ये गुंडागर्दी खत्म हो सड़क बिजली पानी सभी सभी को सुविधा मिले
क्या विकास हुआ है पिछले बार उसको देख करके ही वोट देंगे इस बार
Around 57% voting was recorded in the 49 constituencies from across 10 districts. This is higher than the previous turnout in these seats in the last assembly polls.
During this phase, the turnout for this phase has been very encouraging. While in the previous election, it was about 50.85%. This time on and until now, the information received is that it is 57%. Maybe that it will step up further by 1 or 2%.
In terms of geographical size, 1/5 of the state cast their vote in phase 1. 49 seats were contested across 10 districts which include Samastipur, Begusarai, Khagadia, Bhagalpur, Banka, Munger, Lakhisarai, Sheikhpura, Nawada and Jamui. In a first, security on voting day was not taken care of by the Bihar police but by paramilitary forces. Additional Chief Electoral Officer R. Lakshmanan said there were no reports of any untoward incident.
दो बूथ हैं दोनों बूथों पर एक पे सीआईएसएफ है एक पे सीआरपीएफ है पूरा इंतजाम है
मतदान मोर और लेस पीसफुल रहा है सिवाय एक दो इंस्टेंसेस को दो जगह क्लैशेस के रिपोर्ट मिले हैं किंतु वो पोलिंग बूथ से काफी दूर हुए हैं और स्थिति नियंत्रण में है
A total number of 1.35 crore electors were eligible to cast their votes for 49 assembly seats, for which 583 candidates, including 54 women, contested.
हाँ, डाल लिया वोट, मताधिकार का प्रयोग किया, मुझे खुशी है, और मैं चाहता हूँ कि देश में अब एक कानून हो, और मतदाताओं के जागरूकता का विशेष अभियान चल ही रहा है और चलेगा।
मैं जनता सेक्युलरिज्म के झंडे के नीचे खड़ी होगी, वहाँ पे महागठबंधन को जिताएगी उसी की सरकार बनाएगी
वोटिंग केम टू एन एंड एट 3 पीएम इन 9 कंस्टिट्यूएंसीज पोलिंग इन 4 कंस्टिट्यूएंसीज एंडेड एट 4 पीएम एंड पोलिंग फॉर द रिमेनिंग 36 कंस्टिट्यूएंसीज एंडेड एट 5 पीएम ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट राज्यसभा टीवी
Well, various political parties have expressed confidence that they will win the elections. Let's listen in to the RJD's Lalu Prasad, who is predicting a clean sweep for the Grand Alliance.
टोटल जितना भी वोट होगा मिनिमम 180 सीट हम लोग जीतेंगे नोट कर लेना तो
वेल लोक जनशक्ति पार्टी प्रेसिडेंट रामविलास पासवान इज कॉन्फिडेंट ऑफ हिज विन इन द ऑनगोइंग इलेक्शंस ही सेड दैट द एनडीए इज गोइंग टू विन 90% ऑफ द सीट्स इन द फर्स्ट फेज
180 सीट पर 90% सीट पर हम लोग जीत रहे हैं फर्स्ट फेज में वो हवाबाजी उनका सब निकल जाएगा जन समुद्र उमड़ा हुआ है क्या कहते हैं कि एनडीए के पक्ष में पता चल जाएगा उनको
द बीजेपी दैट इज लीडिंग द एनडीए फाइट मीनवाइल सेज इट इज कॉन्फिडेंट ऑफ अ क्लीन मेजोरिटी
बहुत भारी संख्या में हम सीटें जीत रहे हैं हमारे लोग अच्छी स्थिति में हैं
Joining me right now is senior journalist Nikhil Anand from Patna, Bihar. Well, Nikhil, as far as the polls are concerned, you know, 57% voter turnout in the first phase of polling. Would you say that it's an encouraging start because it's been the highest voter turnout since 2008, since delimitation took place in 2008, as far as these 49 constituencies are concerned? I seem to have lost the phone line there with Nikhil Anand, but we'll try and get him back. In the meantime, of course, these visuals coming to you from yesterday, where the first phase of polling began, where 57% voters came out and cast their vote. It is the highest since delimitation took place in 2008, as far as these 49 constituencies are concerned. The oldest person who cast her vote was a woman from Begusarai district who was 108 years old. We saw several elderly as well as women come out and cast their vote, and that was encouraging to see. But unfortunately, of course, not too many youngsters casting their vote. Nikhil Anand, senior journalist, is joined on the phone line with us from Bihar, Bihar's Patna, of course. But, you know, Nikhil Anand, as far as the voter turnout is concerned, 57% voter turnout, highest that this particular first phase, or rather the 49 constituencies, has seen since delimitation took place in 2008. Encouraging signs, would you say?
The turnout is very commendable because it is up from the last time. And if you take into account the voting trend of last time, that JDU and BJP were in land, and people voted especially for the comeback of Nitish Kumar. And this time, Nitish Kumar is in another alliance with RJD and Congress. And here, Nitish Kumar is completely trying to just save his bastion, and all the constituencies which were which went into polls, that is basically a support ground for Nitish Lalu combined. And here I see that Nitish and Lalu is having little aid in the first phase of the election.
Indeed. You know, as far as the first phase is concerned, we saw almost 60% of the voters who voted were women. So, you know, how much of an influence do you think that the women are going to have on these polls?
Two reasons for women voting percentage showing very good trend. One is these days because of crop production in several parts of country. People in great number,
migrants who
are in situation in Bihar. So people migrating in big number. And because in several villages, maximum of the males who have gone out to work, and the women especially turn out to vote. So that is one reason. And second is because of several schemes launched by Nitish Kumar, women and girls especially, they are really very excited to come out and vote. And 50% reservation in three-tier panchayati system during last year of 10 years of Nitish rule. That has worked wonder that in three-tier panchayati system, a big amount of not only the voters, but Nitish created a lower chunk of political women workers, political leaders, and that prompted women to came out and vote in big numbers. So which way these votes will go, it is not very premature to say and predict even, but I see that because of Nitish Kumar's inclusive growth policy and several schemes, he has really made sure that women come out of their homes and vote in a big number.
You know, usually when there is a high voter turnout, we've seen in the past or previous elections have shown us that, you know, the election is usually lopsided. 51% voter turnout in 2010, 56% voter turnout in 2014. We saw those results going in favor of the BJP. This time around in 2015, we are seeing a 57% voter turnout. So do you think that it's going to go that way, like, you know, or do you think it's going to break? protocol, going to break tradition, and maybe it's going to be too close to call?
Friends, this time people voted in big numbers, but I don't say that it is against the government or for the government, but here is a different kind of situation. Last time people particularly voted in favor of Nitish Kumar because of his first 5 years of rule. He has worked really for the development. This time, because of his unholy alliance, a different kind of alliance, Nitish Kumar has gone into with Lalu Prasad Yadav and Congress, as done by the BJP. Nitish Kumar is campaigning very much on a positive note and going on to the masses with all his positive work he is presenting to the masses. But the whole war of words between the NDA side and the Grand Alliance is between, basically, particularly between some leaders. It is Lalu is involved with in war of words with the leaders of BJP. But Nitish Kumar's campaign is basically, particularly, going on a very positive note. So I say that the voting trend would be really very different, and in the first phase, all the constituencies, the big number of around 20% of 20 to 24% of Dalit voters were there in all the constituencies, and big number of EBC voters. So how these two voters basically will turn out and vote, and their voting pattern will really make a difference.
Indeed. All right, Nikhil Anand, do stay with us. I'm going to come back to you in a short while to talk about some other stories that we're tracking here on Verdict 2015. But for now, we'll slip into a short break. Much more lined up for you on the other side. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Get live Rajya Sabha session. News. Views. Reports and analysis you can trust on social media. Subscribe, follow, like Rajya Sabha Television.
Welcome back. You're watching Rajya Sabha Television. Well, Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed two rallies in Bihar on Monday, one in Jahanabad and another in Bhabua. The Prime Minister launched a scathing attack on Chief Minister Nitish Kumar and RJD Chief Lalu Prasad over the issue of corruption. He accused the two leaders of insulting the legacy of Jayaprakash Narayan. The Prime Minister was referring to a sting video that surfaced showing senior Bihar Minister Avdesh Prasad Kushwaha accepting bribe. Kushwaha resigned later.
अगर 4 लाख रुपए की बोली बोली जाती है, हिसाब किताब उस प्रकार से होता है और सरकार में रहते हुए होता है, तो भाइयों बहनों, जयप्रकाश जी को अगर सच्ची श्रद्धांजलि देनी है, इस पाप के साथ जिस राजनीतिक दलों का संबंध है, इस पाप के साथ जिस गठबंधन का संबंध है, पूरे बिहार में चुन-चुन करके ऐसे लोगों को साफ कर दो मेरे भाइयों।
Meanwhile, Nitish Kumar addressed a rally in Aurangabad. He attacked the opposition, the NDA Alliance, saying they were busy bickering among themselves. He also attacked the Prime Minister for campaigning in Bihar, saying he wouldn't bother to come back for years if the NDA won.
मैंने चुनाव जीत करके गए तो 14 महीना तो बिहार याद आया नहीं। फिर जब चुनाव नजदीक आ गया तो बिहार टहलने लगे। या तो विदेश जाते हैं या बिहार आते हैं।
Meanwhile, Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister and Samajwadi Party leader Akhilesh Yadav addressed his first rally in Bihar as the poll battle among political parties intensified in the state. This is the first time Yadav is addressing a rally in Bihar ahead of the elections. Still with us on the program is senior journalist Nikhil Anand. Nikhil, as far as you know, these rallies are concerned, of course, the first phase of polling is done and dusted, but that's just 1/5 of the way. There are 4 more legs to go. And can we expect the same kind of barbs and counter barbs being made? Because I don't see it going any differently.
Of course, this whole election has really is moving and taking place on our non-issues. And all the parties are contributing to it. Even Chief Minister Nitish Kumar is not different. He is also leaving no scope for other parties and just taking cue from the statements of Prime Minister. He is attacking on him. And more so ever, other party leaders, different party leaders like Akhilesh Yadav, Mulayam Singh Yadav and Mayawati, all those who are coming to Bihar for campaigning, they are also going on the same and attacking PM as well as the Nitish Lalu duo just to create a space for themselves. But one thing is very common that Mulayam Singh Yadav, Akhilesh Yadav and Mayawati all focused on this reservation issue. That BJP, they want to put BJP on a back foot. So BJP is filling itself on a back foot because of this reservation issue. And now I think the beef and reservation issue is settled. The mute spectators, those who are watching and going to the different rallies, the common masses, they are simply... on not very clear and not very active, proactive as where they want to vote and whom to vote. Because I see in all the rallies, there is one commonality that 70% of the masses are simply a mute spectator, they are silent. And these silent voters are simply the ABCs and Dalit voters who are trapped and sandwiched between the very aggressive upper caste and the OBC voters who are very aggressive and campaigning for the parties. So these silent voters will really be looking into the space as where they find it suitable to vote. And it depends on the situation as these Dalit and EBC voters would be voting on constituency basis and district basis where they are having the less social contradiction with the social groups, they will be voting with them. So the campaign and the trends are not pan-Bihar. It is simply will be decided on the basis of different districts, constituencies and the local factors as well. So this election is going to be really different and no poll pundit and nobody is ready to predict even the outcome of the poll. And in the first phase, even BJP people, when you talk to them in private, they are not ready to say how much seats they are gaining. And even Mahagathbandhan people are very cautious in their prediction. So this election, by the time it reaches third phase, everything, fingers are simply crossed for the leaders as well as the journalists and intellectuals even as what is going to happen.
Indeed, you know, interesting contest on the cards and very difficult to call at the moment. Indeed, it is a two-horse race and all eyes, of course, are on Bihar because of the kind of far-reaching impact and because the ramifications that these polls are going to have. It's not just the Indian media that is keeping a close and a keen eye on these elections. It is the international media as well. Nikhil, you know, the entire world seems to be keeping a close eye on these elections because of the kind of far-reaching impact and the kind of ramifications it's going to have as far as national politics is concerned. Well, you seem to have lost the line there with Nikhil Nalanda. But anyways, thank you so much, Nikhil Nalanda, for joining me on the show, on the program and sharing your views and perspectives on several of those topics that we discussed here on Verdict 2015. Moving on now, of course, two Dalit heavyweights are facing off in a battle for votes and prestige in the Maoist-hit Imam Ganj constituency on October 16th. Former Bihar Chief Minister Jitan Ram Manji is taking on the Speaker of the outgoing Assembly, Uday Narayan Chaudhary. Here's a ground report.
जित Jitin Ram Manjhi has a score to settle. The former chief minister had announced his candidature from the Makhdumpur seat when he sought the Imamganj seat. In order to contest against Uday Narayan Chaudhary, the former Bihar Assembly Speaker, the Hindustani Awam Morcha chief's rivalry with Chaudhary is a deep-rooted one.
When Mr. Manjhi was having problems and he was to face vote of confidence, at that point of time, Uday Narayan Chaudhary, as the Speaker, he proclaimed him as to be an unattached member of the House, and some of his followers were also disqualified. So that, I think, from that point of time, this rivalry got converted into enmity.
Manjhi has a tough fight on his hands, for Chaudhary is a member of the Mahadalit Pasi caste. The six-time MLA sees the former chief minister just as an outsider.
जितना भी बड़ा पहलवान वो भेज दे, जब तक इमामगंज डुमरिया और बांके बाजार की मिट्टी का खून और यहाँ के लोगों का खून मेरे नसों में दौड़ रहा है, तब तक एक नहीं दस जीतराम मांझी आएगा पहलवान बनके, उसको यहाँ से मुंह की खानी खा करके जाना पड़ेगा।
Manjhi is betting on his Mushar caste status to carry him to victory. The NDA claims that shift in the loyalties of some Muslim voters will favour the BJP, LJP, RSLP, HAM alliance.
15 साल से हैं उदय नारायण चौधरी यहाँ से विधायक हैं, विधानसभा अध्यक्ष हैं, विधायक 20 साल से हैं, विधानसभा अध्यक्ष हैं, फिर भी जो विकास होना चाहिए था वो हुआ नहीं, जानमाल के जो हानि होती है बराबर यहाँ।
The stakes are high for both candidates. Both are laying claim to being the most important Dalit leader in Bihar. For Manjhi, a loss will weaken his position in the NDA. It will be equally unnerving for Chaudhary, who is positioning himself as the Dalit face in the JDU.
In 2014, both Jitin Ram Manjhi and Uday Narayan Chaudhary fought Lok Sabha elections unsuccessfully as JDU nominees. However, in 2015, with Jitin Ram Manjhi deciding to take on Uday Narayan Chaudhary at his home turf, will make this contest a very keenly watched one. Reporting from Imamganj with camera person Sudhanshu, I'm Kriti Mishra for Rajya Sabha Television.
Well, barely 55 kilometers from Patna not so long ago, Jehanabad used to be out of bounds for people gun-toting Maoists called the shots here. But things are slowly changing. For voters and candidates, both. The big issue in these elections is development.
Jehanabad, a town that once hogged the headlines for caste wars and massacres. Along with places like Gaya, Arwal and Aurangabad, it was mentioned as the killing fields of central Bihar. Today, however, winds of change and the power of the ballot have changed its narrative. Local residents are more focused on issues like irrigation and basic amenities.
हम लोगों को पानी की जरूरत है ना कि नीचे जमीन में बोरिंग है और ना सिंचाई कोई साधन है जो इस साधन को पूरा करेगा उसी को हम लोग वोट देंगे।
Jehanabad has a significant place in both Hindu and Buddhist traditions. Voters say that with medieval sites like the Dargah of Sufi Saint Hazrat Bibi Kamal Rahmatullah Aulia, the Sun Temple and ruins like the Barabar Caves, the place can be developed as a major tourist destination. Upper caste Bhumihars and backward caste Yadav voters are the deciding factors here.
देखिए महागठबंधन पूरे बिहार में यहाँ नहीं पूरे बिहार में कोई टक्कर नहीं है। नरेंद्र मोदी के जो झूठा वादा था सब लोग समझ गए हैं।
हम लोग विकास के मुद्दे पे चुनाव लड़ रहे हैं और नीतीश कुमार जो विकास के बात करते हैं, नीतीश कुमार जब से राजद से गठबंधन किए हैं, लालू यादव से गठबंधन किए हैं, तो पुनः बिहार में जंगल राज कायम हो गया।
मैं जहानाबाद की पैदाइश हूँ, जहानाबाद में मैं पैदा हुआ हूँ। मैंने जिस स्कूल में पढ़ाई करी है वो राजा बाजार इलाके में पढ़ता है। मैंने बचपन से आज तक वहाँ पानी का जमाव देखा है। मैं सिर्फ डेवलपमेंट की राजनीति करने आया हूँ।
From political violence to the politics of development, Jehanabad has come a long way.
Influence of Naxals has declined in this area due to the change in the socio-political landscape. A reason for the improvement in the situation is also attributed to Bihar's bifurcation in 2000. Provision of roads, electricity and irrigation facilities would dominate voters' minds in upcoming elections in Jehanabad. Reporting from Jehanabad with cameraperson Sudhanshu, I'm Kriti Mishra for Rajya Sabha Television.
That's it on this edition of Verdict 2015. Have a good day.